Good evening and welcome to the Village of Romeoville's workshop meeting this Wednesday, May 17, 2017 at 6:01 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Here.
Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards?
Here.
Trustee Griffin?
Here.
Trustee Aguirre?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. How about Mr. Trustee Clancy? You lead today.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. First item we have on the agenda this evening is ordinance 171364, ordinance approving a special use permit for a plan unit development, final development plan for B&W truck repair at 667 Parkwood Avenue. Mr. Rockwell, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. The special use permit this evening for B&W truck repair at 667 Parkwood Avenue. B&W purchased this property a few years ago. It was the former Siebert Landscaping Company. I lost track. I think it's been at least 7 years since it's burned down. And they purchased it 1.5 acres to do truck repair and inspection. The applicant's proposing 11,700 square foot building with an area for truck repair and inspection buses. And there will be 4 bays for the repair that you can. Maybe I got a better picture there. During the concept plan, and that was all the way back last September, it was known there was a dispute between the neighbor to the north, Wayne Castles, Caneo Graphics, and who had been driving on the property for several years to get to his property. The Planning Commission Village Board requested the property applicant try to work it out and have an access. Trucks would go through the gate. Additional arguments make it a private matter. Nothing like a deadline to fix it. Mr. Casile is here indicating they came to an agreement last week. So I'll continue like they came to an agreement and we won't talk about that. So since the concept plan for the building has changed to precast concrete, no longer any code exceptions for the metal, and the only exceptions are to allow it to reduce the front yard setback from 25 feet to 10 feet and reducing the side yard setback from 20 feet to 16.93 feet. These reductions are necessary to move the building southwest enough so that the truck can have a maneuver into the safety lane that you're seeing on the north. The applicant has also provided the village a 60 by 45 foot easement area for the future project to relocate the Parkwood lift station right up here in the corner on their property. The Development Review Committee has relieved the proposal, and the Planning Commission reviewed the concept plan way back on 9/13 of last year. Village Board redid it on 9/21, and the Plan Commission just had their public hearing on it on 4/25. And the recommended approval on compliance with the staff comments, the plans and everything are in. I think we're awaiting your vote. Mr. Casile is here if you want to talk about the other issue, but for our purposes of planning, everything was fine. The other issue was how do they pull in and out of their property.
Very good. Since that's not a matter before the proposal tonight, that won't be something we'll discuss.
Right.
It's not a part of the process today. I mean, if you got an agreement, that's great.
No,
I mean,
just one question.
Can you come up? Oh, wow.
What's in that packet of documents is not what was agreed on.
Okay.
Between us and the other neighbor.
Okay. Mr. Rockwell should have probably, as you discussed, like, and again, this is not an opportunity to dialogue about any changes to the thing. If there's any changes that need to be made, we can either entertain tabling the project, or revisions can be made in a separate application later.
Your Honor?
Mr. Rockwell can have those discussions. We will probably entertain tabling it this evening.
Need a motion, Mayor?
No, we don't, because we're not up to the voting portion. So, but we can also, we can still talk about some of the design elements that, if anybody has anything about the structure itself. But you're talking about some changes to layout?
Yeah, because I have a new layout for.
If you could, continue that discussion with Mr. Gold and Mr. Rockwell, and we'll have council, and we'll probably table it tonight in order to make that combination.
Thank you.
And unfortunately, I'm sorry if they didn't explain to you. It's just, yeah, we can't make a change like that on the fly. Very good. So given that, though, on the building and structure itself, seeing that we may see some additional slight adjustments to the site itself, but I believe the building itself will stay as proposed here. Any other comments or questions from the board till we probably, and I'll let you table this until the following meeting with any of the revisions on the site plan, which I'm sure is all regarding flow of traffic. So anything on the building itself?
Do you want to make sure we're going to table it? Is that what?
Yeah, I think we're going to entertain the tabling until the next meeting so that we can, because I think it all, in order to avoid them, the applicant having to reapply and go back through the process for a change in the site plan, we would need to have that revised plan before we can vote on the final. So rather than have them go back and through the entire process, we'll probably entertain tabling it for the time being in order to allow them to accommodate that and follow up on it.
Okay.
But anything about the, I mean, I don't anticipate them, and Mr. Rockwell probably doesn't anticipate them changing the building itself. So if there was anything specifically on the building, that would still be fine. I mean, we could also.
Yeah, well, just one question, Mayor.
Sure.
Steve, you mentioned about the outside building. We are going to give variance, or we're not?
No. When we first got this, they wanted to build it in metal way back.
Okay, wanted to build that.
And now they've changed it to
very good
concrete like everybody else.
Excellent. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Good. Well, seeing we'll probably see this again, but if there was any additional input on that, I think we're pretty good on the building itself.
Our recommendation is to pull it off until we see the
table
agreement.
Until, we're going to table until
sure
next meeting.
Everybody's in good shape.
Okay. Very good. Next, we have Ordinance 171375, Ordinance approving a text amendment to a zoning code, Chapter 159, regarding food and truck operating locations. Mr. Rockwell, please.
Oh, that's me. Very simple. Currently, we do not allow food trucks in the B3 Regional Highway District. There's been requests from the board and others to look into doing that. On the B3 Highway Regional Shopping Districts, this language has been forwarded by the Plan Commission. Food truck or food truck operator is subject to the requirements of Chapter 129, where we created the food trucks, but only when the food truck in question is operating in connection with the operation of an establishment licensed to serve alcohol beverages in the Class M1 or the Class O liquor license issued by the local liquor control commissioner in accordance with provisions 112. So you can only have the food trucks if you're have a liquor license and own specifically if it's those two liquor licenses.
Very good. When we first passed it, we really only had users that were interested in the more manufacturing industrial zoning. Obviously, we had a new user come in that has a lot of interest in food trucks. Food trucks is interesting, more recent, relatively recent still. Thing that's become very popular and interested in. There's very good quality ones. And Mr. Rockwell, if I'm correct, there is a pretty lengthy and extensive approval process through the county health department as well for food trucks.
Yeah, I actually have a list. We asked the county, and there's some 50 trucks that have been approved by the county. And several of them, when we cross-check them, do work with our businesses. Once they get the county license, which is good for the year, if they want it to be, they get to come to us, and we will give them a license as well to these. Actually, this makes it two establishments are only ones authorized to.
Yeah, so it's a fairly comprehensive process. These are not fly-by-night operations for the most part. These are very well-established food truck operations. They have to go through a lengthy application process. It's still very limiting, even what we're doing here. But it does allow for some creativity. And it, while trying to strike a, what is important, which is a healthy balance with traditional bricks and mortar.
And you were very specific in making it food trucks. We have those other requests, but those are like food carts.
No food carts.
Carts behind trucks.
No food temporary tents.
Has to have a motor. And run.
An actual real motor. It's got to be clean and it's approved by the health department and then by us. And again, it has to be in connection with an existing operation that meets the qualifications, and it's extremely limited in scope. But trying to be innovative at the same time. It was interesting because this conversation came up in a recent meeting with some of my colleagues, and they're also facing, you know, this question of how to strike that healthy balance where we're not creating too much competition for traditional bricks and mortar, but also allowing for sort of creativity. I think this, and they were very eager to see what we were able to produce on this.
And Chapter 129 goes further that if there's restaurants or other things within 300 feet, they do have to give permission.
Yeah, so if there's an existing bricks and mortar operation, they have to sign off on it in cooperation with it. So there's several layers of protection and review involved in the process. The food trucks will have to be required to live by all the same standards and rules as everybody else and taxes and all that stuff. So it was a pretty good review of it. Your staff did a great job kind of coming up with ways to take what we already had done with the previous incarnation of this. And as when we passed that one, we kind of noted that, you know, it was a first run. You know, we're just starting to kind of look at what it takes to address this. Some places don't address it at all. It's kind of the wild, wild west out there. I think we're probably pretty progressive in trying to accommodate the usage, but at the same time, again, we don't want it to create an undue burden on any of our existing operations either. So thoughts, comments?
Yes.
Board?
Yeah, Mr. that Palmer? Is my main concern. The food business is a business that can struggle greatly, mm-hmm. and the competition concerns me that it's going to be great on them. 300 feet is not a huge distance. Just my feelings. I just think it's kind of tough. It works well for Metal Monkey because there is no competition over there. If there's a restaurant 300 feet away and you got it, you know, it's just my concern.
I have a question, Mayor.
Sure. Trustee Rochelle.
If I understand this correctly, Steve, this has to be in conjunction with the business that has the liquor license. Mm-hmm. They have to invite them, right? And then they have to be a sign off by a neighbor who may have a restaurant within 300 feet.
Right.
Has to be in agreement with it.
Rich will help me a little bit, but there's two ordinances. Here you're doing the zoning part to allow it in the zoning code. The second part, when you created 129, that's where the 300 feet and all that is. But yes, if you are pulling in a food truck that's going to serve cupcakes or tacos, then if there's a cupcake or taco dealer there, they have to give you permission. Or if there's another restaurant serving food, they still have to give you permission.
Okay.
And Ms. Ballmeiter is correct. It's only 300 feet. Which
right.
In some of the shopping centers, that's not the whole shopping center, and some it is. But there's only the M license is Metal Monkey, and the O license is Iron and Glass. So it's only
only two existing locations.
Right.
And in this case, it would encompass the center. And the other thing is they have to, it has to be allowed under their landlord license as well. So that's where we're trying to keep it fairly restrictive in scope, so it just wasn't open-ended.
Just a concern.
No,
I
agree. It was one of the big concerns that we had brought up as well. And it's limited to in usage to a number of times they can do it, Mr. Rockwell?
Yeah, they can do it, I think, three times a week. And they're supposed to, on our ordinance, they got to tell us when they're coming, all
Rich.
Those sorts of things. This is just sitting here zoning.
No, it's once a week, wasn't it, Mr. Vogel?
I don't think so.
Yeah, once, yeah, with a maximum of three or four times a month. With a maximum of three times a month. So, yeah, it's a maximum once a week and maximum three times in a month. So,
okay.
So even that, you know, beyond that, so you have to get permission from everybody.
Mm-hmm. Right, and that's a big key right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, and then you have to, it's limited to in scope the number of uses as well.
I got you.
So, Again, with the thought that, you know, we don't want to create that undue burden. Trustee Clancy, please.
I think you basically answered the question I was going to ask, how often, and do they have to have an acceptance every time, or can they give out a preview, you know, like set up a schedule or a date of when they're going to be there?
However,
what I was thinking of is the entertainment center, the event center, as far as big tournaments or something.
They're going to be exempt. They're in a different situation.
That's a different class.
But
Just ask.
Our permit is good for the fiscal year till December 31st, so we'll take that letter for that time unless somebody wants to withdraw it. But otherwise, we're going to consider it good. Otherwise, we spend a lot of time going and asking.
It's an annual re-up on all of it, so they have to do it every single year. So it's not open-ended.
Thank you.
So if it doesn't work out this year and the other restaurants say, you know what, we don't like it, we're not comfortable with it, then they're done. I mean, that burden's on them.
I have another question, and that is the one, because I'm thinking about the other one, the Iron and Glass location. Mm-hmm. What about the parking? See, how big are these trucks? Are we going to lose parking or no? You know what I mean?
They will.
The rest of the requirements in 129 is you have to be at least 5 feet away from sidewalks. I know those not in driveways and those. So in most, Iron and Glass has got the convenient situation of being able to go around back. Well, not the side, but around back. But they have a lot of parking front and back.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So we thought about that. Yeah, that was. It's thinking the same exact thing we were when we think about it as well.
One other question, just Metal Monkey, I understand there's nobody else around, but just Iron and Glass, they're going to have to get permission from the other two restaurants in the strip mall before they can do it, right?
Right, correct.
Okay, good, thank you.
Now, and conveniently for them, the other thing is too, hours of operation on this, the one restaurant's not even open.
Closes at 3 or something.
Yeah, and they've already indicated they've already had the conversation with the other one. So.
Great.
And their landlord, which was also keenly important. Because landlord could ultimately just say no.
Yeah.
So. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. One question. If I'm, say, Pepe's next to Iron and Glass, can I limit them to certain types of truck? Or if I say yes, it's okay, they have them, they can have them?
I guess if we get a letter from them that has all that kind of stuff, we're going to talk about it. I'm assuming Pepe's is going to say yes or no. If there's starting to be other stuff on there, Rich, I don't think we anticipated that.
I don't think that's, you know, strictly speaking, that would be a private matter between Pepe's and, you know, the food truck operator.
You know, like Tacos by Giselle, they might not want them sitting right next to their Mexican restaurant.
Yeah, I mean, in a situation like that where it was a competing vendor of similar or near identical food, my thought would be likely that the property owner of the fixed restaurant would just say, nope, we're not going to consent to it. You know, we'll give you a blanket consent provided you only do things that don't directly compete with our business. They can certainly condition their consent to the food truck on any terms and conditions that the two parties can agree to, and whatever agreement results from that, I mean, I think we wouldn't have an issue with it, really.
That's a land and or business owner situation, though.
Exactly.
We're not regulating it to that point, and probably shouldn't.
They had that objection. They're allowed to have that objection regardless.
Okay. Yes.
They want to negotiate between the two.
That's between
them. Within their own agreements with the landlord, too, this doesn't, you know, if there's an exclusivity on their usage, again, say, you know, Pepe's has an exclusivity within their lease, that they can be the only Mexican restaurant on site, that applies to the food truck as well.
Okay.
That carries over.
Okay.
That wouldn't limit those pre-existing agreements as well.
So we've built some protections in there.
Yeah, okay. There's multiple.
Good.
And then, again, in this particular case, all the parties had indicated they had already had come to that understanding. So.
And my staff's just looking for a yes or no. If that all happens, we'll tell them to go away and come back with a yes or no.
And in this particular case, I believe that the landlord is actually the primary owner or investor in the Pepe's as well. So I think it is unlikely we'll be seeing a Mexican food truck at Iron and Glass anytime soon. But again, that's why we also have that trigger in there. Again, it's only good. You can only do it for a year. You know, after that, you know, once the year's up, then it's time to, you know, if everybody, it didn't work out, then you know, if they didn't come to terms, that's why we have that annual review, so. Very good. We'll give it a test. If it doesn't work out, we can always bring it back a little bit, so. Kind of, it's worked out pretty well so far with Metal Monkey, so we'll see. It's a new thing. It's one of those things. It was like we said, did that one. It's something that, you know, we'll keep an eye out and do a review and see how it does the first year and see if there's any complaints, so. Very good. Thank you for all your work on that. And a lot of creativity, because again, this is something pretty new in the industry, and so we just got to take a look at it, so. Next is resolution 172312, resolution awarding the contract for a decorative street lighting phase two project for Utility Dynamics Corporation, the amount of $469,955. Mr. Zabrocki's not here.
I'll take this one, Mayor. Thank you.
All right. I didn't know which one of the two of you. You're both kind of smiling, but I didn't know who was gonna feel this one.
Both very eager.
Did we?
Watch the team one out.
So Joel looks a little more comfortable than you tonight, Eric. So you gonna take this one?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you.
Thank you. The Department of Public Works is requesting approval of a contract with Utility Dynamics Corporation of Oswego for the installation of decorative streetlight poles. These poles are the same poles that were installed last year along Arlington Drive, and these will replace the ComEd lighting along several other minor collector streets in Hampton Park. And those locations would be Belmont Drive from Route 53 to Montrose, Dalhart Avenue between Arlington Drive and Belmont, and the last part would be the remaining dead-end portion of Arlington Drive west of Montrose. Four pre-qualified electrical contractors provided bids, and Utility Dynamics provided the low bid of $469,955. We had originally budgeted $400,000 for this decorative street lighting project, and propose to defer construction of the South Creek Parkway bike path connector to fund this difference of approximately $70,000. This program seems to be really popular, and we'd recommend that this resolution be approved.
I'm going to caution you about that South Creek Parkway trail connector. That also continues to be a priority.
Yep. We would defer that for 1 year. That there's $90,000 budgeted for that. Ultimately be a pretty popular bike path. You have the wetlands over there by Pinnacle, and it does give you access to a lot of the Weber Road businesses.
What we can do is, there's still a lot of hoops to be jumped through with that bike path because of the wetlands and businesses and so forth. So the one reason why Eric recommended to push it back is chances are we may not get to it this year anyway. But what we can do is we can go ahead and plan for it, and if it goes smoothly, we can go ahead and do it and then take it out of some other savings. I mean, so we can be flexible with it. If it moves quickly, we can go ahead and put the 90 grand back in and do it, and then look at another project, you know, so we can be flexible if the board chooses. But that's one of the reasons why Eric picked it, is because, you know, it may take a little bit longer to get this project completed than initially thought. So we can be flexible, whatever right. The board
desires. As long as we understand it, you know, because that connects in a whole big part of the section of the trail system.
There's a lot of construction in that corridor right now.
Right.
And
I understand that. I just want to make sure the folks at home understand it's still a priority as well. These are both great projects, but we need to make sure that one stays a priority too. So, got a lot of people who like to bike throughout the community, so, and that's a big gap sitting there right now. So, very good. Questions, comments from the board? We got the visual up on the stretches that are going to be done, and for the folks at home, ideally we'd like to continue to do street lights. You know, depending on funding. It will take a number of years to complete and do street lighting. It's not going to happen overnight. We're talking about infrastructure that took decades to go in. It will take quite some time to enhance and upgrade it as well. So I know we often get questions of, when am I going to get the streetlights on my block? We're committed to continuing to try and do it, but it is funding dependent. It was something that we will endeavor to continue to try and do a little bit each year, like we do on some of the other things, but it did take a long time to put all these lights in. It will take some time to replace them, so just so folks at home know that. So, I think we all agree that continuing to improve this and continuing to make those investments and that infrastructure is something that will continue to be important for some to come. So, questions or comments? Bless you.
Just question: what criteria are we using to pick the streets we're doing immediately? Or
Eric,
we kind of laid out kind of a general phasing map, and first of all, we're concentrating on the primary collector streets through Hampton Park. Belmont is certainly a well-traveled and high-priority location, and Delhard kind of connects with the uptown square area, and some of the criterion is we want to certainly address some of the locations near schools. That's coming up pretty soon. Those kind of things that are really more critically important areas.
Gotcha.
Oh, that's very good. I mean, yeah, start with the higher traffic at areas, higher visibility areas, and certain, and then move into the side streets eventually. Any other questions or comments?
Mayor?
Yeah, Trustee Schultz, please.
Yes, thank you. I agree wholeheartedly with you, Mayor, regarding the South Creek bike path. We need to keep that up there as a priority because that is a critical thing for our residents over there. I also have the utmost confidence in our group here, as they have shown in the past to always come in under budget on many things that we have budgeted. So the budget is early, a lot of time. I believe we'll do just fine. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. Any other questions, comments? There you go. The first round of lights looked really nice. These will be nice as well.
Yeah,
it's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
It's beautiful for us.
And yes,
I want them in my neighborhood. Just saying.
Well, piece by piece. they're looking nice. They're a nice addition for those areas. So hopefully, we continue for going forward. Very good. If there's no other questions or comments, we'll move on to 172364, a motion to approve the Economic Development Commission strategic plan. Don Caldwell, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. The Economic Development Committee is appointed by the Village Board, and the makeup of it is various stakeholders in the community. It consists of business owners, educational representatives, residents, developers, the Three Rivers manufacturers on there, just really a good mix of different stakeholders in the community. Their role needed a little clarification with regard to how it works with economic development. So what they did is staff, Ken Griffin was part of this as well. We met with them to help identify how their role fits into this. And what they did is they went through various sessions, they did various workshops, and they spent a lot of time on looking at how they can help the community grow, how they can enhance and work on some of the already things that we're doing and how we can benefit from those. And they really put a lot of work into this. It was really important to them. And then we wanted to identify, you know, what those strengths and weaknesses were and what their role is going to be with that. So they actually identified four critical elements. The first one was partnering with schools and businesses for a better skilled workforce. So we have various representatives on there from the high schools, colleges. So what a great resource that is. So we sat with them and said, how can we partner with them and, you know, get this information out to the community and get this information out to the businesses to just make that a better partnership. So they've identified some different areas of how they can do that. We currently have a brand, our partners brand, as you see on some of our marketing when we do economic development. They identified certain ways to keep that brand going and how to get that word out to different stakeholders as far as getting more development in the community and how to work with the Economic Development Department to do that, but to keep that brand going, to not mix it with anything else, to keep it with its own identity. How can we attract visitors and businesses from outside the community? You know, the Development Department, the mayor, they do a great job. The board does always talking about the community. We go to sessions and everything to try to market Romeoville and to attract businesses. But how can we work with people in the development side to do that even better? So they came up with some great ideas on how to expand on those resources. And then finally, to retain and expand on our existing businesses. They're in the community, they're talking to other businesses, so there's another partnership that we can gain from that. How can they help with our retention program that, you know, the board has already kind of talked about doing, and what's their role in that? I will tell you, it is very important to them. They want to succeed just as much as everybody in this room does, and they're willing to put their efforts into helping that as much as possible. And they have some great ideas, and so they're just looking for a little clarification and support by the board of those four elements and how we can all partner together to do them. It just clarifies their role a little bit. They're going to work with staff on stuff that we're already doing and just not create anything new, but kind of push more ideas out and focus on those things. So a lot of time was put on this. Rick DePago is the chairman of the committee. He spent numerous hours working on this too, and I don't know if Rick wants to say anything, but that's kind of the focus of the whole thing. I don't know if Steve want to add anything to that. Ken Griffin was part of it. It's a great partnership, and I think we can really benefit from some of the ideas they have.
Very good. It's a good guideline. Really, it highlights a lot of things that we're already involved in, but how to incorporate the strengths of the individual members into that process as we move forward, and just, you know, kind of a better guideline and going, you know, as we move forward on a lot of things. A lot of things that are included and already underway or implemented, but it gives a better just kind of general outline for all how that should interact and how they should work with our staff and our officials as we go forward. So, no, it's good. Any other questions or comments?
Thank you, Mayor. I just want to say, you know, I want to say many thanks to everybody that serves on the EDC. I mean, this is like a volunteer type of work, and they're doing a great job. You know, I was a liaison back years ago, and it's an exciting group, and I think this is something that we definitely need, and whatever we can do to help keep it growing and blossoming and keep it more creative, I'm all supportive of that. I think that's what we need to do to help grow in Romeoville. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. Any other questions, comments? You were there.
I was, yes, and I am. You know, we've got a great group of volunteers and a great cross-section of the community, and I think this is really all we're trying to do here is to kind of firm up the commitment of the village and everybody here at this podium that this work is important to us. We want it to continue, and we want to take seriously and try the best we can to implement the suggestions that they make. So that's really all I have. I see my fearless leader, other leader, is coming to the podium, so I'm going to defer to him.
Junior leader, just to...
Go ahead.
Thank you for allowing me to speak and having us here. I want to start by saying that the team that is assembled within the village here that kind of is our guide for this commission, they've really have set the foundation of what we put together so far. The one thing I want to stress as the spokesperson for all the members, from the faculty members and professors and business owners and all the great minds that we have, Trustee Griffin, we all have the same goal in mind, and that is how can we continue to help Romeoville stay on this tremendous path that they're already on. Collaboration, I think, is the greatest resource that we can have, and I think that's the greatest part of the Economic Development Commission. So if we can, you know, this guidance and allowing us to at least have some direction, I think really becomes a catalyst for continuing to move forward and really attracting some opportunities that, you know, we may not have had opportunities to attract otherwise. So, and I thank you for the opportunity to allow me to continue in this role.
Very good. Any other comments or questions? Excellent. Next we have resolution 172314, resolution approving agreement to rescind the agreement dated 12/18/2013 between the Village of Romeoville and Indoor Sports Management Group LLC to provide staffing at the Edward Hospital Athletic and Event Center. Don Caldwell, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. As the board's aware, we have a current contract with Indoor Sports Management Group. There's 2 years left on that agreement for the Athletic and Event Center for the management of it. The current contract limits what they can do in that facility, so it doesn't compete with a lot of our programs and stuff that we have going on at the rec center. So we took the opportunity to look at their contract to see how we could expand on this a little bit. Am I on the wrong one? No. I seen that up there. I thought I was on the wrong one. To expand on it a little bit more. And so what we did is we met with the current owner, we met with the rec center staff, and we came up with an opportunity to kind of come up with an agreement where they provide the staffing and we kind of handle more of the contracts, we take in all the revenue, and it really gives us a better opportunity to program that center more. You know, there's a lot of programs the rec center can host there. There's a lot of ideas that the current staff have on bigger tournaments and stuff like that that I think we're really going to benefit from that. The details of the contract I've outlined for the board. It is for the remaining 2 years of their contract, so it'll rescind the current contract and go for another 2 years. They will provide all the staffing for it. The financial agreements are outlined for the board there. Just trying to come up with some of the big things here. They're going to run the concessions on it, so that's one of the things they will not collect revenue, or that we will not collect revenues on, is the concession stand. They're going to continue to run it themselves. They'll pay us a monthly fee for us to allow them to get the revenue from that. The outdoor activities, if we have more of our special events there, we'll run the concession stands ourselves, and then we will get the revenues for our own events. If we require additional staffing for the special events that we host there, he can bill us additional for that. But for the general running of the center, all the staff is included in that $350,000 that's been identified.
Very good. You know, as the facilities evolved and we've had an opportunity to look at usage and think of creative ways in order to try and now, you know, first couple of years, you need time to actually establish patterns and schedules, and they've done an excellent job at that and bringing in a lot of the bigger events. And now there's opportunity to take it to the next level, and this through the staff discussions was a way to do that and kind of further evolve the facility and what we're doing with it. It's been very successful so far, and in no way, but there's opportunities there to do more. Especially on the village's own programming. I think it's a good way to have an incremental step toward that goal. And I thank the staff for coming up with some really good ways to do it.
And the one thing I wanted to add, we are still fine-tuning the agreement, so when the board approves this, we would ask that they approve it based on the village manager and attorney final review, because we're still making some tweaks to the agreement.
And the tweaks regarding the indemnification language, so just a very minor tweak to the indemnification language. The crux of the agreement is not going to change at all, just the lawyer stuff.
Some of the legal language, but the basic business points of the agreement that Don has outlined this evening, they're not going to be affected.
Very good. Questions or comments? Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I think this is a good agreement, and it's nice to see that we're moving to the next level. This building is used more often than I think a lot of people in town thought it ever would be, but it can be utilized even more for some other types of events, and it is. I am very glad that we're taking this step to be even better utilize it, which ultimately provides more services and benefit to the residents.
Absolutely.
Very good. Other questions? Oh, Trustee Schwartz, thank you, please.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, this was the plan from the start, and we're moving forward with the plan. One thing that I did catch my eye, and I'm glad to see that we got it documented here, that we will be taking control of the marketing, the website. I think that's very important, because marketing, obviously, is the key to keeping that place up and running and going. So I was glad to see that here at item H. So you did a fine job there, legal counsel.
Thank you, sir.
That's all I had, Mayor.
So just, if I can just add one thing, so just think of it this way, is the rec center's running it, they're organizing it, we're outsourcing the employees, so to speak, to run the day-to-day activities. And Fred, or the management group, IMG Management Group, is the company that's running our employees to run it. And we are in charge. We have this group to provide the employees to operate the center.
And still working with us on the major bookings.
Absolutely correct. Yeah, and we're using his resources, correct.
Right. It was always the goal to integrate. Actually, in a lot of ways, it really is a testament to that we're almost really ahead of where we thought we'd be, ultimately, is what this means. And it was always the goal to progress with it, but it's really turned out to be a little bit faster than we thought. So that's actually part of the good thing, part of it. So I think we were fortunate enough to have the talent to take it to that next level, and Kelly and her crew do an excellent job with what they do. So. Looking forward to what they do with it. So, very good. Any other questions or comments? Hearing none, we'll move on. Next, we have then Resolution 172315, waiving the bids and authorizing an agreement with Harbor Contractors for construction management services. Don Caldwell, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. We have three construction projects coming up: the Deer Crossing Park restrooms and concession stand, Animal Control Center, and then a small storage facility added on to the Edward Hospital Athletic Center. We have worked with Harbor Contractors before. We had a good relationship with them. We are recommending that they are the construction management team again for this. They will come back to the board and identify the guaranteed maximum price for this. The board has approved the budget for $1.7 million for all three projects. The majority of it is for the concession stand and restroom facility. So once they have, I think it's 21 days, I want to say they have to review the contracts, go out and get some bids, and then come back with that price. We have a very aggressive schedule. It's a four-month construction season that we're hoping to get this done, with the focus being on the restrooms, hopefully being done by the fest. I mean, it's going to be very aggressive. I don't know if we'll be able to achieve it, because it's already, June's right around the corner, but we'll see how it goes. But that's the directive that we have. I do have some renderings. This is kind of the concession stand and restroom facility. It's 1,500 square feet, and it'll kind of match the decor of this building with the brick and everything else. It's just another elevation of it. It'll be located next to the park, which is a great location for it, because there's a lot of people that use the park and the pavilion, so it's a good location for that. Animal control. The Animal Control Center, we are going to work with some other entities to try to get some stuff donated, some work donated. We have had a couple of businesses already make financial donations towards the project, but the Animal Control Center partially will be donated, and we'll come back to the board when we have that guaranteed maximum price and identify, those savings that we're getting from that. We are getting some savings from the adjacent property, which is being developed by DCT. They're utilizing our property for their stormwater management, and they're doing a lot of some of the work for us too. There's kind of a trade-off there. We'll kind of report on that when we come back. That's the Animal Control Center. It has 9 dog runs. They also have exterior dog runs from them, and what's nice is it has some adjacent property that the dogs can get some exercise outside. The addition for the proposed addition for the Athletic Center, we're going to try to get about 2,200 square feet. It's right in the center of the back of the building, where you currently see where the garbage is, the toters and stuff are. That's where we're going to try to add on to that. It makes it real convenient for us to pull the basketball courts out and right into that storage area. And then we have some space on the corner of Phelps and Town Hall, where we'll move those needed for the garbage disposal and everything there.
Very good. Again, last one, again, back to being successful quicker than we probably even thought we'd be as successful. A little storage for all the different things that happen there. And ultimately, it'll be more cost effective, because it's easier than storing it somewhere else, and it's a lot faster. So, no, that'll be a good investment. So all the projects that were already approved with the budget, so this is really just for the bringing in a group together to coordinate all those. So and obviously try and get them done very quickly, so all of them, because they're all very important. So questions, comments? Okay, very good. Next we have ordinance 171369, ordinance amending chapter 159.073 B3 permitted uses. Mr. Vogel, is this the aforementioned?
This is the same thing that Mr. Rockwell had already introduced, so we had a little bit of a duplication of efforts, and I would just ask if the board would remove this from the agenda and from further consideration, because we've already gotten that matter covered.
Okay. And next we have ordinance 171376, ordinance authorizing the boundary line agreement between the Village of Romeoville and the Village of Lamont. Mr. Vogel, please.
Thanks, Your Honor. Thank you. We can take a look. The blue essentially represents our current corporate boundaries. Green would represent current Lamont corporate boundaries. And as you can see, there's sort of a black border on our territory. There's sort of a gold border that's somewhat but not entirely on Lamont's boundary. And basically what the agreement is doing is saying that Village of Romeoville is not going to annex farther east than the line that's shown in gold on the map. Portions of it, strictly speaking, are not east. There's a northerly component to it. And then likewise, the Village of Lamont is not going to essentially annex farther than the heavy dotted black line going in a generally westerly direction. There is a component of it that's, I think, probably quite a ways off in the future, but Lamont had indicated that it would consider, you know, obviously we're on the other side of the river at that location, and they'd indicated that they'd consider extending essentially some water capacity and service to us, contingent on the village and or potential future developer of a portion of this area committing to do some of the infrastructure upgrades necessary for that. So I think that's, you know, kind of a future potential option that it's nice to have for development in the future, but I don't know that it's anything that we're looking at a very serious or concrete level right now.
Very good. So the gold line is the line that we're talking about?
That would represent as far as we're going to go generally to the east.
Okay. And the map's a bit confusing here. The Lamont growth line, the dotted line.
The heavy dotted black line, that's correct.
Okay.
And then essentially anything, you know, in between the two area, in between those two lines, it's available for annexation by either party.
Hey guys, we need to talk about this a little more.
Fair enough.
I don't know if anybody else has any input. I don't think this clarifies enough of it.
Fair enough.
I have a question, Mayor.
I agree.
So just since I agree, I don't have a problem tabling this at all. I don't have a problem with that. So Bluff Road, let's look at Bluff Road for a second. So they're saying they won't come south of the yellow line? Or they can't?
We're saying at that particular location, the function of the yellow line is to set a northern limit beyond which we would not go.
That we would not go.
That's correct.
All right, so we would not go north of Middle Bluff Road.
Right.
Is that Woodridge up there? Or is that a different boundary line now?
If you get in the Bluff Road area, the immediate parcels to the north are probably typically going to be small residential, unincorporated Will County parcels.
Okay.
Once you get beyond that residential component, you probably do get primarily into Woodridge property.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's essentially that area is between the lines and would be available for either party depending on how their growth takes place.
No, this isn't as extensive as I think our previous, what my under previous discussions were. We're going to need to talk about this further.
Okay.
I agree.
I just have one more too. It looks like there's a non-contiguous piece down at Smith Road and 135th right there by the open sign. Is that correct that we jumped?
This is, unfortunately, this is not acceptable. So I think we just table it for now.
Yeah, makes sense.
Continue it on.
Okay.
Very good. Next, we have ordinance 171377, ordinance amending Chapter 90, dogs and cats, and Chapter 43, fee schedule of the Village Code and Ordinances. Mr. Vogel, please.
Thanks, Your Honor. What we had here probably arose out of a number of separate discussions we had concerning a variety of individual animal enforcement related concerns, and given that we had probably a half a dozen, you know, originally probably half a dozen or so separate ordinances put together, the thought was to bring everything that we were thinking about forward together at the same time in sort of a single comprehensive ordinance amendment to address the various animal issues that have been floating around.
Okay. Any questions, comments, anything else? Board? Anything you want to add to that, Mr. Holden? Mr. Richard, please. Trustee Richard?
Yeah. We're excluding bees. We don't have bees in the village anymore?
Beehives.
Beekeeping.
We have beekeeping in the village. Yep, gonna need to table that again too.
Okay.
All right, guys, we need to sit down and talk about both of these more extensively. That's getting tabled today if everyone's in agreement. All right, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. We'll move right into the regular board meeting of the Village of Romeoville this Wednesday, May 17, 2017 at 6:54 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Here.
Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards?
Here.
Trustee Griffin?
Here.
Trustee Aguirre?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee Clancy, will you lead us in the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. What do we got? We don't have anybody from the public here, so I'm going to assume we don't have anybody signed in. we have a motion for consent agenda?
So moved, with the exception of 1369, 1376.
No, this is the regular consent agenda.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We're not to that one yet.
Yep.
But you're on it. do you have a motion for the regular consent agenda? All right. Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Chavez. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Within that consent agenda, we have the minutes 170673, approval minutes May 3rd, 2017 workshop meeting. Minutes 170674, approval minutes May 3rd, 2017 regular meeting. 172359, approval bill schedule A. 172360, bill schedule B. 172362, approval bill schedule C. 172363, previous bill is Schedule D, Resolution 172310, Resolution Establishing a Development Security for Public Stormwater Erosion Control Improvements for CN Group at 525 Anderson, located at Sunrise Business Park. Resolution 172311, Resolution Establishing Development Security for Public Stormwater Erosion Control Improvements for Thomas Toyota, located at Rose Plaza Business Park. And Resolution 172313, Resolution Acceptance of Public Improvements for Grand Haven Marketplace Lot 2.
So moved.
Second.
Motion to approve by Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, could I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. We don't need to do PH 172251. Mayor's report, we have...
If I may, Your Honor?
Yes.
Would we want to consider opening that hearing and continuing it or tabling it to our next meeting date, simply so we don't have to republish and conduct another hearing?
Okay. We may likely not, but yeah, I mean, we can continue. We'll open the public hearing for PH 172251, public hearing and boundary line agreement between the Village of Romeoville and Village of Lamont. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Clancy.
Second.
Second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, could I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Would you like us to leave this open then, or close it and continue it?
I think my vote would be to table it the next board meeting.
Okay. I'm going to ask if anybody's here tonight for this public hearing. I'm going to ask if anybody's here for this public hearing. I'm going to ask if anybody's here for this public hearing. Seeing there are none, I will entertain a motion to table this till the next.
So move.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Chavez, second by.
Second.
Trustee Aguirre. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Next we have ordinance 171378, an ordinance amending chapter 112, alcoholic beverages of the Village Code of Ordinances. That one's removing a license class for establishing that this closed. Motion?
Second.
Motion by Trustee Chavez, second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none, could I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
And ordinance 171379, ordinance amending chapter 112 alcoholic beverages of the Village Code ordinances, and that's also removed for a different. No, that's that's the addition for Thornton's. I'm sorry. Oh, there's one other one we're probably going to be removing.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Chavez, second by Trustee Pallmeyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call?
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Also in my mayor's report, sadly I have to send my condolences to the family of Paul Russick, great family, just a wonderful man, lived in Grand Haven, visited their home, just absolutely saddened me to hear his passing. True friend of our community, so, and all of us, so. Also want to, on a more positive note, congratulate all the police and fire department award winners the last couple of banquets that we had. Just amazing, outstanding group of people, both in the fire and police departments. There's so many outstanding things. I mean, I'll tell you, you ever go to one of these, there's so many great things that these departments do. Very special people we have working for us. They always pick out somebody that was the top one of the year, but really, honestly, there's many to choose from. So I had the good pleasure of going to Irene King and speaking to the first graders about Career Day. Wonderful group of students that just had some really great questions, I'll tell you. First graders. It was exciting to be over there. Also had a group over from AVM for the student council. They came over and visited as well. Excellent group. Many of them graduating and going on to the high school, but I assured them we'll see each other over there as well. So I look forward to meeting the new crop that comes in from AVM next year. And I want to thank everybody who was a part of the Metra groundbreaking. Just an outstanding event. Steph did a great job putting together and with all the Metra staff. Very exciting project if you didn't already see everything. And I'm sure Kevin will have it up on the air soon for those who might want to see it. Romeoville High School Honors Assembly will have their Rotary Top 10 dinner tomorrow. Community Garage Sale will be held on Saturday. Romeoville Arts Society will be holding a ribbon cutting on May 25th. Cruise and Scare will be held on May 25th at the Edward Hospital Athletic and Event Center. Misswood will be hosting their fireworks on May 28th. Memorial Day service on the 29th. It's a May's a busy, busy month, folks, as we said at the beginning of May. And groundbreaking for Discovery Park on May 31st, Relay for Life on June 3rd at the Bloomberg Town Center. Romeoville Toyota will be having their groundbreaking on June 7th at 10-11 a.m. Village offices will be closed on the 29th in observance of Memorial Day. And if all works out well, my father, who's a disabled Vietnam veteran, will be visiting us for Memorial Day and be a part of our ceremony. And I'm happy to announce that. And congratulations to all the upcoming graduates. That's the end of my report. Clerk's report, please.
Thank you, Mayor Noak. The Valley View Educational Enrichment Foundation met on Monday, May 15th at the Bolingbrook Village Hall. The Valley View Educational Enrichment Foundation golf outing is Thursday, June 8th at the Bolingbrook Golf Club. The proceeds from this outing will benefit the Valley View School District students in Bolingbrook and Romeoville. And the next meeting is next Wednesday here in Romeoville at the Village Hall. So that's May 24th at 6:30. The Community Service Council met on Tuesday, May 16th at the CSC office in Bolingbrook. The Community Service Council Policy Committee continues to update and develop policies and regulations to the current standards. I'd like to congratulate all of the award recipients at the Police Department Awards Dinner on last Thursday, I believe. The Civilian of the Year was Tina Blankenship, and the Officer of the Year was Amanda Knowles. Amanda Knowles was also the American Legion Officer of the Year. And at the Romeoville Fire Department Awards Dinner on Saturday, the American Legion Post 52 Firefighter of the Year was Thomas Jockman, and Thomas Jockman was also the Fire Department Firefighter of the Year, and the American Legion Post 52 EMT of the Year was William Murray, and also the Fire Department Firefighter of the Year was also William Murray. Congratulations to all, and that's the end of my report.
Very good, thank you very much. Citizens, commissions, committees, and liaison reports. Where'd my list go? Trustee Aguirre.
Our fire and police commission, the vetting process continues for police candidates that are on the current police candidate list for future employment. Two police candidates are now in the police academy.
Our commissioners went to Decatur for the Fire, Illinois Fire and Police Commissioners Association Spring Seminar for their training to discuss state statutes and case law. The commission's next regular meeting will be Tuesday, June 13th, 2017. And that's all I have. Oh, okay, that's all.
Very good. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. No report on REMA this evening. Next planning and zoning meeting scheduled for May 23rd has been canceled. That's all I have.
Very good. Trustee Clancy, please.
Thank you. As far as beautification, I have no report tonight. And as far as the rec center, School Spirit Day will be held May 23rd from 3 to 6. This is a free event for middle school children. Includes pizza, music, sports, and games. Each student must have a signed waiver to attend. And then you can really tell it's getting to be summertime when we're cruising the square. Car featured shows will be starting at May 25th at the Edwards Event Center from 5:30 to 8. The Stingrays will be performing from 6 to 8. So bring your families out and enjoy the evening. And that'll be it. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, please.
Thank you, Mayor. After all the wonderful things we said about the, you know, the Economic Development Commission tonight, we had to cancel tomorrow's meeting because of lack of a quorum, because at this time of the year, as everybody knows, people's schedules get crazy. So other than that, the Veterans Commission will be meeting again on July the 18th, but I want to remind everyone that on Monday, the 29th of May, we'll be holding our Memorial Day ceremony at the Doc McCartan Memorial, and our guest speaker is going to be Steve Huber from Abraham Lincoln Cemetery, and we're also getting an opportunity to meet Mr. Noakes Sr., so we hope everybody can show up for that on a bright and sunny day, and that's all I've got.
I think it's been 17 years since he's been in town.
Really? Wow, we'll have to give him a welcome when he gets here.
Trustee Paul Miner.
Thank you, Mayor. The next Special Events Commission meeting is Tuesday, July 11th, 2017 at 6 p.m. at the Rec Center. For the Finance, Village offices will be closed on May 29th in observance of Memorial Day. The Village's Memorial Day service will be held at 10 o'clock at the Edward Doc McCartan Veterans Memorial at 11 Montrose Drive. Spring cleanup week begins on May 22nd. Garbage pickup will be on your regular scheduled day with unlimited pickup of large items. No tires, hazardous waste, or construction materials will be taken. Please make sure any additional items outside of your toter are properly contained in either plastic bags or containers that are no greater than 32 gallons in size and do not exceed more than 50 pounds. Animal tags are also now available. For year 2017-18, all cats and dogs are required to have a Village tag. Tags cost $4, $2 for seniors, and a current rabies certificate must be presented. Tags may be purchased at Village Hall. Maximum combined number of animals that allowed at a household is 4. I thought I just read something to the contrary to that, but. The budget document and PowerPoint presentation is available on the Village's website under the Finance Department Transparency Annual Operating Budget and Audit Reports. And in regards to the Humane Society, I've spoken to some of the homeless and displaced animals, and they're very happy to have a new home soon. That's all I have.
Very good. I think we're all very happy to get that done for them, too.
So. Yeah.
Trustee Chavez.
Yes, thank you, Mayor.
Maybe like we're showing up in my backyard.
The Youth Outreach Commission update is basically applications for the Youth Outreach Program scholarships are available at the Romeoville Rec Center and the High Point Community Center. These scholarships are available year-round. Also, they wanted me to mention to you that the updated version of the Youth Outreach Guide, which has a lot of great information on it, is now available online at the Village website, www.romeoville.org. This guide serves as a directory of local services for Romeoville families. So please, if you get an opportunity, go to our website, look up Youth Outreach Guide, some great information in there. The next commission meeting will take place on Monday, June 5th at 10 a.m. at the Rec Center. As far as VOR-TV, now that the weather's kicked into the summer mode, I just want to remind everybody, Romeo Fest is coming. It will be here quickly. It always comes quickly. And they are always looking for volunteers to help out with their VOR-TV, learn how to produce programs, video productions, direct programs, camera operations, editing, hands-on training, all free if you volunteer and work with VOR-TV. It's a great opportunity for the young folks, retired folks. It's a great opportunity, and I just want to remind everybody out there, we can use all the volunteers possible for Romeo Fest. It's a huge event.
For all those amateur photographers who are taking, you know, the family reunion movies, and they're always, and then they cut off the heads and everything else, that's a great place for them to learn how to improve their skills at video.
You're absolutely correct, Trustee. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. Let's see here. Village Manager Report.
No report.
No report. Very good. New business.
Move for consent agenda with the exceptions of ordinances 1369, 1376, 1377, and Resolution 2315 pending attorney review.
How about...
All right, so we're going to take those out, so the consent agenda minus those at the moment. And then maybe we'll lop the tablings together. Okay.
Did we get 1364, Mayor?
What was that?
Did he mention 1364?
1369. Consent agenda minus 1364, 1369, 1376, 1377, and 2315, correct?
14.
No, yes. 15. Oh, no. Oh, no, you're right. I'm sorry about that.
14.
Yes, 14. All right, let me read that again.
Yeah.
Just to make clarify. Consent agenda minus... We should have just voted on them individually.
Yeah.
Why don't we just do that?
Probably be faster.
If you want to rescind that motion?
You know what? I will.
Okay. How about I entertain a motion to... for 172364, a motion to approve Economic Development Commission strategic plan.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Richards. Any further discussion? Hearing none. Can I get a roll call, please? We may have a little bit of...
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Ordinance 171364, an ordinance approving special use permit for a planned unit development, final development plan for B&W truck repair at 667 Parkwood Avenue. So a motion to table to the next board meeting.
So moved.
Motion second. By Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Pallmeyer. Any further discussion? Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
And Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Ordinance 171369, ordinance amending Chapter 159.073 B3 permitted uses.
So moved. Go.
That one's motion approved.
That was removed.
Right?
Yes.
Yeah. Motion approved by Trustee Richards, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
1369, wasn't that removed?
We're not. That's why we're going individually.
No.
Okay.
That motion is rescinded.
Okay. Give me the names again.
It was Richards and Griffin.
Thank you.
This one, it wasn't supposed to be removed. This is the usage for the companion.
Right, to the food truck.
For the food truck.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
That's why we decided to go individually. Ordinance 171375, ordinance approving a text amendment for Zoning Code Chapter 159 regarding food truck operating locations.
So moved.
Second.
Motion to approve by Trustee Richards, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Ordinance 171376, ordinance authorizing a boundary line agreement between the Village of Romeoville and the Village of Lamont. Motion to table to the next board.
So move.
Motion second. By Trustee Chavez, second by Trustee Pallmeyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Palmer?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Ordinance 171377, ordinance amending Chapter 90, dogs and cats, and Chapter 43, fee schedule of the Village Code and ordinances, because clearly we need to remove bees. Entertain a motion to table this one till the next board meeting.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Palmer, second by Trustee Aguirre. I think they'll let you have it. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmer?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next we have Resolution 172312, resolution awarding a contract for the decorative street lighting Phase 2 project of the Utility Dynamics Corporation, the amount of $469,955.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Clancy to approve?
Second.
Second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Palmer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next we have Resolution 172314, resolution approving an agreement to rescind an agreement dated 12/18/2013 between the Village of Romeoville and Indoor Sports Management Group LLC to provide for staffing at the Edward Hospital Athletic and Events Center pending final manager and attorney review.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Palmer, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmer?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Resolution 172315, waiving the bids and authorizing an agreement with Harbor Contractors, Inc. for the construction management services.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin?
Second.
Second by Trustee Palmer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Palmer?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Trustee Chavez, please.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Just want to start by thanking everybody who's been involved. I want a special thanks to Mayor Noak and Congressman Lipinski and Will County Executive Larry Walsh for doing that groundbreaking for the metro station. I think that's a huge milestone in our growth here in Romeoville. It shows promise and just continued efforts that we continue to show with other municipalities and other forms of government to help our municipality to move forward. I just want to say many thanks to everybody that participated in making that happen. Also, I want to remind the residents that when making repairs, to please you make repairs on your home, big repairs especially, to please use contractors that are licensed and bonded through the Village of Romeoville. You know, this is the season where they're knocking on doors and all kinds of outfits are out there, so please be aware. And also just want to remind everybody our first fireworks being held at Misswood's coming up end of the month, May 28th. Looking forward to that. And the Summerfest is starting with the fireworks, then we got Memorial Celebration, and our first Rock the Ville, June 8th. So school will be letting out soon, so drivers beware of the kids running around. And with that, that's all I have, Mayor. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Palmer, please.
Thank you, Mayor. It was a privilege to attend both the police and fire awards dinners. It's amazing to see the amount of talent that we have in this and dedication that we have in this community from both of those departments, not to mention all of our departments. But it was a pleasure to be able to see those people get the awards for some of the extraordinary work that they do for us. Metro groundbreaking, so many years of work has gone into that project. I mean, it's well over 10, I believe, since we started looking at that possibility, and here it is basically in our laps. And you can't help but thank all the people that have put their work into that, because many hands, many hours have gone into that project. And that's all I have.
Good. Trustee Griffin, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Yeah, we are in a roll with the new metro station. I mean, wow, we're right up there with the big boys now. To add to what Trustee Chavez said, We happen to be getting a new roof, and I know that there are people running around knocking on doors and calling people, and just be very careful who you deal with and make sure that they're reputable and that the village has approved them. The Valley View Educational Enrichment Foundation, as the clerk has mentioned, is going to be the 8th of June, and with wonderful planning, the Romeoville Boosters golf outing is going to be the 9th of June. So if you're up to golfing 2 days in a row, you have two great opportunities, both of which are going to benefit the kids in the high school and our community. I want to add my sympathy to Darlene Rosick. For those of you who don't know Darlene and Paul, they're very active in the Golden Agers, and they would often sit here after the Senior Olympics down in Springfield, often in matching outfits to collect their gold medals for bowling or whatever. And Paul's going to be deeply missed. He was a great friend and a marvelous miniature railroader who had a great collection in his basement of miniature railroad things that he would share with everybody. We're all going to miss him. So our sympathy goes out to Darlene, and that's all I've got.
It definitely will be missed. Very special man. Trustee Clancy, please.
Thank you. I was fortunate enough to attend both the police and fire awards banquets. And let me tell you, I think both departments are second to none all around. Just to hear the stories that they had, it's just amazing. And they're just so easygoing. It's nobody was worked up. Everybody got everything done that they were supposed to do. And it just shows the talent that we have on both of our departments here. And like Trustee Joe said earlier, watch out for the children in the streets. And Monday, the 29th, 10 o'clock, and we'll be looking forward to meeting a very special man that morning. And also, with the Metro groundbreaking, it just goes to show that we are on the right track. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I want to congratulate, of course, our police officer, civilian, firefighter, and EMT of the year. Not only those four, but again, as has been said before, and as needs to be said again, that both those departments do a phenomenal job of keeping our residents and our business owners safe. They're here for us whenever we need us, all hours of the day and night. Never not there when we've needed them, and I thank them for that. I want to congratulate all the graduates, whether it's Creative Play coming up next week, yes, or on through high school and college. Congratulations to everyone moving on to whatever your next level happens to be, for all your hard work. My condolences do go out to the family of Paul and Darlene Rosick on the loss of Paul. Again, as been said before, Paul was a good man, great man. Had the pleasure of being at their house as well. Got to know both of them. Just good people, good people. Definitely a loss to the village of Romeoville. The golf outings have been talked about, but I do want to make sure everyone understands what they're raising money for in this case. The Valley View Educational Enrichment Foundation raises money to give to programs throughout the district that the district doesn't have money to pay for. Things over and above that classrooms need, for usually more for an educational project. The Romeo High School Athletic Boosters, and that one's Friday, June 9th at Carillon, they raise money to enhance the sports programs specifically at Romeoville High School. Both of those outings are always a very good time. They're also very well attended. They raise a lot of money for very good programs. So if you're a golfer and want to get out, I would recommend either or both of them if you have the time. And don't forget our Memorial Day service, May 29th, 10 a.m. Very important to remember our veterans. And yes, we are into the summer season. First concert of the year is actually tomorrow night at Mistwood. So if you want, looking for a night of free entertainment, tomorrow night is their first one. That's all I have.
Very good. Trustee Aguirre, please.
I have, congratulations. I also attended the fire and police awards banquets, but I says going to a lot of awards banquets, I'm gonna have to work on the treadmill a little longer. I'm told eat half the food, but anyways, congratulations to all the guys and women. They give themselves selflessly, so they're all awarded, but special thanks to all the, or congratulations to the awarded ones there.
and excited about the metro station. The groundbreaking went great. I know a lot of my clients weren't even aware that the metro station was coming this way, and everybody's really excited knowing that they don't have to drive excessive just to get to a train and enjoy the city and, you know, everything that goes in between. So, but, and that's all I have. Oh, and just real quick, the Chamber, our business after hours, it's going to be Wednesday, May 24th at Anytime Fitness from 5 to 7. So that's all I have. Thank you.
Very good. With that, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Pallmeyer.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Good night.